Hey, today we're gonna build the Maxtrix 1000 bed. This is the core bed in the Maxtrix system. This is the bed that literally can convert into over 40,000 different bed combinations. It doesn't matter if it's twin, full, or queen, with all the extension rails and accessories and so on and so forth. This is the core bed. So we're gonna show you how to build this one. If you can build this one, you can build the rest of the Maxtrix system. So to do that, I'm just gonna go and change my clothes. See you later. When you get a Maxtrix box, on each box where there's hardware, there's a red strap, actually says hardware. Open the box on that end. First thing you do is to retract all the hardware and make sure you keep it in a safe place. When you have done that, retract all the hardware pieces and put them in a certain place in the room. The next thing is, make sure you have all the hardware. This is the hardware you actually get when you build a bed, head, footboard, two rails. So basically, the first thing you do, you literally just take the cross dowels off. When you've done the cross dowels for each corner of the bed, two bolts, two cross dowels. You also get the tool with it, a little angle tool. It's very convenient, great to work with. If you have a power drill, of course, it makes things a lot faster, so that's what I'm gonna use. When building a Maxtrix bed, there is three holes you can actually put your bolts in, but because you only have two bolts, that means we have two settings. The two settings that we have, it is the bottom two holes, that's the two holes you use when a bed is on the ground. The top two holes is the holes you use when a bed is off the ground. So whenever you use any kind of ladder, you use the top two holes. So today we're going to build a bed on the ground, so we're going to use the bottom two. First, insert the cross dowels, and the cross dowel has a little bit of a slip to them, so if you don't put them in right, you can just turn them with a screwdriver. Just pop them in. Take the headboard a little bit off the wall. And just angle it, and you can very easily do it yourself, just put the cross dowels in. You can hand tighten it, just so they're actually attached to the headboard, that's fine. So when you've done that now the rail's actually secured on one side. And just down to the other end, you do exactly the same. That's it, nice and secure. Now take your power drill, just make sure it's a little bit of a loose setting. And just keep on tight until it actually clicks and you're good. Your bed is built. Nice and safe, nice and sturdy. The next thing you're going to put in is the slats. One thing you have to make sure that you do, it is to make sure that the black strap stays on top. First thing you need is the four screws. What you have to do, you have to make sure this is tight. You can see right now it's fairly loose. So you take the bottom slat, and just push it down behind, one tight. Push all the way down, the other side. And when you do, to make sure this is tight, you go down the other end. And you literally pull as hard down as you can. We've done that. As you can hear, this is extremely tight, and it should be tight. The tighter it is, the safer and sturdy the bed becomes as well. So the next thing you do, it is, instead of just putting all the slats in at one time, let's take another two screws and put them in the middle. And the reason why in the middle is because sometimes you have over a long span a little bit of a bow to it. So by putting them into the middle first, it actually gives you the opportunity to make sure that you get the bed totally tight. And what you do, you just press your body up against it and use the same slat as you used over there, squeeze them together. So now the bed is tight together. Then from now on, you literally just take the remaining screws and put them into the bed, which I'm gonna do now. As you can see, it doesn't take that long time to pull a Maxtrix day bed together.